today. It's 4:20 in the afternoon. And if it wasn't obvious from my voice, I'm a bit sick. And my last video that I recorded, I'm not even sure what day it was. But I talked about how I was feeling sick, like my head and stuff. Well, it turned out I did get sick. So that is that. Sorry, I'm on my laptop right now, putting some background visuals. But anyways, a little update. I don't even know. It's what is it? I think it's, well, I don't know how the whole Korean time works, but today's the 29th, so technically from like the time zone, LA time zone, I don't know what that is called, but tomorrow is Tae's birthday, and like people already like on Twitter said they're already celebrating and stuff, so maybe it's already the 30th over there. I have no idea how that works. I'm sick, but I'm gonna eat chili. I think with chili, either way, it'll make my running nose like gone, because I'll be like, my mucus will be coming down. It's actually been pretty disgusting for this video, so I might just stop recording before that all happens. I don't have tissues, so like I've been getting the restroom toilet paper because it's like the softest, the softest like paper that I can blow my nose with. So yeah, except I locked my door and everything, and I didn't bring any. So I set up my chips with some Tapatio, and I put some lemon juice on it. And to drink, I have this. I don't know if you guys can see. No, it has a little bit. I dropped some out of my chip. It just. That was so stupid. Why did you do that? The chips don't taste the same. Anyways, this is sponge. Basically, it's Mexican homemade punch, I guess, that people make. Doesn't taste the same, but I'm still gonna eat it. Was this chili overcomes the thing. I mean, really, I was talking about Tae's birthday. What is it? So, I recorded the video that I put up today on like 16th or 17th, I don't know, the day. And I was talking about how I'm going through my Tae phase, which is basically like, he's standing out the most to me right now at the moment. So that's what I mean with Tae phase. I explained in the video how I change members. And yeah, that's true. which I think is good because each of them is like unique and stands out in their own way. So I guess I catch up on that, and like I don't just stick to one. What else? I actually still have my wallpaper that. Okay, I think that was when in like MMAs or in the other one. And that's when that was. But yeah. I don't know how this video is gonna sound again. I said this in my video that I recorded, like the last video, because the mic thing, I recorded and it sounded off. I don't know how to set it up, like, oh my gosh, I'm so bad. Like, I thought I'll just connect it, you know, but I don't know. I've looked online and people like connected to an aux cord to the thing, and then they have this other connection and they connect it to that. And it was very confusing. But I didn't understand exactly what it is they wanted me to do. But basically, I got this. I ordered it. Hopefully it helps out. I don't even know what the purpose, like, if this is gonna help out or not, but hopefully it does. And hopefully, like, with that I can, the sound doesn't crack like it did in my other video. So yeah, my apologies if the video has cracked noises. And if it does, I'll try muting it, or like, or something. That way, for those of you who are, have headphones on and stuff, it like doesn't sound so loud. What else? What else? I'm still applying to other jobs. I did have an interview on Thursday for some cafe thing, and I didn't go. it's because we talked on the phone before on Wednesday, the day before the interview, and the guy told me, you know, like, for part-time, the days for the thing are Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And I already mentioned how I don't want to quit my other job. I want to keep it, so I'm looking for something from Monday to Friday. So, like, it didn't already work with my schedule. So, I was like, there's really no point in me going to go do the interview. So, I didn't show up. Later that afternoon, I got an email saying that the position was already filled up, so, like, they got someone. So, yeah. I didn't really feel bad about it. Because I really don't want to leave my current job right now. So, yeah. But I'm still applying to jobs. I applied to two earlier today. I'm trying to find more office assistant jobs. Because that's kind of what I want to do or get experience from. The thing is, like, people, like, want experienced employees, which I'm not. I'm trying to get experience in that, so people don't really, like, I guess, take it my application seriously. And then there's, like, other ones where, like, they want you to learn how to, or know how to do, like, these use these programs, and I'm just like, I've never been heard of it. So, like, yeah. But I've been applying to a couple that are like entry level, like they say they'll train you and stuff, but I haven't heard back from them, so. Like, is there something wrong with my resume? Or my cover letter? Like, I don't understand. But yeah. I'm still continuing to apply. I did stop like Saturday, Sunday, and I think Monday this previous week because it was the holidays and stuff, and I really didn't feel like applying during the holidays, so I did stop. But I got back into it. So, yeah. I have to get something soon. Send your good vibes to me, guys. I really want to get an office job. I have also like applied to other positions for like a personal assistant. And I did one last time and like they'd asked me about programs and like numbers, and I have no idea what he was even asking. I was like, I don't know any of this. Like, but for the position, for the personal job assistant, the position said entry level, like that they'll train you and stuff. So I felt bad. I was like, I don't know any of this, but like in the position or the application thing, I said, like, they're willing to train you, so I shouldn't have felt bad because I'm like, well, the position like is so that they can train you and you can be good at it, right? But I still feel bad for not knowing what it is, what they were asking. So, yeah, I don't know. I never got called back for them. I did get called back for some H&R office assistant one, but it was so far away from my house or even from my school. So I was like, I'm sorry, but it's too far away. I don't want to commute that much for a job that's just seasonal, because you know, taxes is like a seasonal job. At the beginning of the year, people do it and stuff, and then it dies down after. So, yeah. I didn't go to the interview. Plus, the lady never texted and responded to me. So, I was like, okay. Anyways. That's it for right now, I think. I think I'm just rambling. On now, so I think I'm gonna let you guys go. If you follow me on Twitter, you know that I was like, I rewatched Cable Girls. It's some show on Netflix. And I finished it. Like, it was the second time I watched it, I think. I watched it more than once, basically. And Netflix still hadn't put out a season two. But, you know, they had said that they were gonna bring one out. So at the time, I was like, I was a bit frustrated. Because they still hadn't released season two, so I tagged Netflix and I'm like, yo, where's season two at for Cable Girls? And they took it out in season two on Christmas Day, I believe. It is the 29th, so 4 days have passed and I still haven't seen it, but it's mainly because I wanted to see it Well, I'm at work, so I can pass the time, so I saved it for tomorrow. But I already downloaded all the episodes onto my iPod, so I can watch it at work. I'm super excited. I personally hope she chooses not her first lover, the other guy, the stepbrother or whatever, brother-in-law of him. Just 'cause, like, I think he deserves someone like Alba, but at the same time, you know, Alba has lied to him, so he might feel like betrayed and stuff. So I don't know how he's going to react to like the whole thing. He could end up like being a dick about it and stuff. So I don't know what's gonna happen, but like I hope she chooses the new guy rather than the her first love. I might change my mind midway, like let's say the other guy, I think his name is Carlos. I've read Fernando or something like that. Francisco, I don't know. But I hope she chooses the Carlos guy. In the new episodes though, he might act like a dick, so I might change my mind because I'm like, oh my gosh, why are you being such a dick? So again, I might change my mind midway through the episodes, but right now, like how the season one ended, I'm like, go for Carlos, girl. I honestly though thought she should have so came clean regardless of like the cover up in the last episode rather than her hiding it and getting caught. Like, come on, like you had the perfect opportunity to come clean and you didn't take it. Like, come on, girl, what's wrong with you? She can't go on her whole life in a relationship, and didn't he propose? Like, how do you expect to live with him knowing him not even knowing your real name or your real story, you know, or history and all of that? Like, it's obvious it won't work out that way, so like come clean about it. But she didn't, and that upset me. But yeah, we'll see how that goes. Again, I'm currently rooting for Carlos. I just don't like how sketchy this new the Francisco Fernando guy is. Plus, he's not even cute. So like, yeah. Plus, his wife, Francisco Fernando's wife, just crazy. Like, holy cow. I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm also watching Mischievous Kiss. It's a Japanese show. Real life, like it's not anime. And I'm about to finish season one. I didn't know, but apparently there's a Mischievous Kiss 2, so I downloaded some episodes from there so I can continue it. And I do know like there's like this other one called Playful Kiss. It's a, basically I think like a Korean version of that show. I might watch it, but I don't know, the storylines may be too similar, so I might not want to watch it right after. But I think I definitely am gonna watch it at some point. So yeah. Oh my gosh, I also finished watching Stray Kids. All the episodes, I binge watched them. Let me see my boogers. Oh my gosh, hold on. Okay. Take two. So I finished binge watching Stray Kids, all their episodes. I watched it in 2 days basically, like I split it half and half. And I liked the show and everything, like, it was good. I just felt like they made the boys suffer through all the eliminations, and in the end they ended up like, okay. Because of your energy of vibe together, you know they're gonna let them all debut together, like. Like, I'm happy that they all got to debut together, but like, it was pretty stupid, like, turn around twist type of thing. And yeah, like, I don't know. I didn't like that part. I am happy that all of them got to debut together, because I personally like Felix's voice, like, the raspy, deep voice, like, it's really cool. And for Minho? I don't know how to pronounce his name. I just think he's like really not only I think he's really good at dancing, and I too think that in his last performance, like on Elevator, in the last episode when he performed that, like I personally felt like the good vibe from him, like he stood out to me. Normally, the one that stood out to me was the cute one, I can't pronounce his name. I know it starts with a J, but he's the smallest one, the Magne? I don't know how to pronounce that word either, but he's the youngest one, basically. And his face is, like, just so cute, when he smiles and stuff, like, you just keep looking back at him. But in that performance in Elevator, I kept like my eyes on Minho, like throughout the entire song, so I really thought he improved in that way, which I'm happy. I think, you know, they had to go through the eliminations to sort of grow and to really put lots of effort and work into it. So I think that like opened their eyes, like, okay, for Felix, oh, I gotta practice my Korean. And Minho, he has to make sure he brings it to the stage. Like, he's really good when practicing and everything, but like when the stage, he needs to really learn how to bring it and to like not like vibe or like stand out basically, and not just like whatever. I mean, I'm not even like qualified to make these remarks, but like, yeah, I don't know. This video, man. Also, when they had the episode for YG versus JYP, the guy who covered Shawn Mendes, oh my god. His voice, freaking amazing, and he's trying so much. Like, they're showing like the pictures or videos of him performing when he was small. Like, he had longer hair and everything, like, and then now he like cut his hair and he's all grown up. Like, I think he's really, you know, he's really talented. I think he's gonna definitely be someone in K-pop. I just think he's so small, like. And then there was like a 13-year-old in the YG group, so I was like they legit have no childhood. They practice and practice and practice. I think that's super crazy. So yeah. But anyways, that's my thoughts on Stray Kids stuff. Yeah, I'm gonna go because I think this video is long enough. And I actually don't feel so sick from my nose because I blew my nose out before my take two. So, my nose feels so much better. My throat is the one that is like, I feel it. It's like itchy, like, you know, when it like scratches when you swallow and stuff. It kind of hurts. Like, it's like that. Anyways, for real this time. I'm gonna go. I hope the mic worked to its best potential and it didn't crack and do all that weird noise. And yeah, have a good day, guys. Or well, it's Friday, so have a good weekend. But then again, I don't know when it's going up, so I have no idea. But have a good day, have a good morning, have a good weekend, night, and all that jazz. Bye.